What's going on, everybody? It's Gauss311 here, and this is Power Star Golf, which is the Xbox One golf game, pretty much the only Xbox One, actually the only golf game, I think, for either of the new systems that is actually available. No Tiger. I actually do not have my Xbox 360 anymore, so I cannot make Tiger videos anymore. And when I picked up my Xbox One, I actually got rid of my PS3 and my 360. So, because I couldn't justify having so many consoles, and I've just been, playing the new stuff, and, so, I can't make videos for Tiger anymore, until the new PGA comes out for the new systems, and then I'll be doing that, I'll be into that. So this is my only golf fix I can even do right now. So this game is kind of like Hot Shots Golf-ish. The courses so far seem to be not as, Hot Shots, sometimes the holes get a little goofy. These seem to be so far pretty straightforward. They're a little goofy. This game, but it's like Hot Shots, it's a three-click system, and the golfers, are individual, they have their individual stats and everything. Like, we got Frank Weaver here, who hits the ball, has a lot of power, compared to the other one I have so far, we have Reiko Kobayashi here, who it doesn't have much power, but is more accurate, and is a little bit more spin than he has. We have Henry Copperbottom here, who we cannot play yet until we unlock him. Cairo Flynn, again, can't play until we unlock. Master Lausche, who actually I'm waiting to unlock. He looks pretty cool. And then Dominique Ryder, who looks like the last golfer. So it looks like there's six golfers. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, there's six golfers. And four courses. The game's $20. Four courses is kind of like, really? For $20, though, it's not bad. There is a downloadable content thing down here that is not lit up, so I'm hoping that they add some more courses. Hope they actually do courses and not just new golfers, because I would like to actually get a couple more courses. The game is enjoyable. It's fun. I like the Hot Shots type of golf. And the Mario Golf stuff, I used to play that all the time when I was younger, and it's similar to that. So, you also have caddies that give you ability boosts of certain types. The abilities are kind of cool. They're kind of powerful so far, but they don't give you a whole bunch of them. Like, you only have a couple around. So we have Kirby here, who his skill is to shows you the exact path the ball will take and set up a non-putted shot, provided you strike it perfectly. And then we have Astrid here, and her is a putt prediction, which basically is putt preview. She gives you putt preview, like the Tiger games, but you only get like two around or three around or something like that. I think you can build it up where you can get more, but it looked like eight was the max. You can't use it on every hole. So I wish Tiger did that. If they had putt preview, that you only get a couple times to use it, and you can't just use it the whole damn time. So those are your caddies. You could also share a caddy, which is interesting. Like, if your friend has a caddy who has a lot of perks, you can actually borrow their caddy, and then I believe your friend will get experience points for that. There's also, it also works the other way around. There's a rival mode, which sounds pretty cool, where you can play your friends, or other people's rival. Like, so say Cryptic got this game, for example. And I'm assuming he won't, because I don't think this is his style. I think he likes the more of the real stuff, which I do too, for the most part. But anyway, say he gets the game, and he sees that my guy shot 3 under par on the first course. He could challenge me. If he beats me, he gets bonus XP. But if my guy beats him, I'll actually get XP for my guy, even though I never played. So it kind of has that Forza thing, where you have your guy out there playing and giving you XP even when you're not playing, which is pretty cool. So there's a career mode I haven't touched yet, and I'm going to start with that for this. I also have played a bit. See, I'm level 7, but I've only really played 4 rounds. I played 18 holes once and 9 holes 3 times, I think, just to get the feel for the game so I didn't look like a complete idiot. So I have 15,000 credits. The way you unlock stuff, and there's a lot of stuff that looks like to unlock, which I also like, because I like games where you can unlock. There's a lot of unlocks, so you can keep playing. There's things to do. You can see here, like, we have different woods, irons we're going to unlock, wedges, putters, balls, caddy perks, is up there somewhere, right? Yeah, I don't know where it went. Yeah, caddy perks, balls, caddy perks, I actually did flip to caddy perks, and boosters, so there's different things. I haven't spent money yet. I was going to wait until I started making the videos to spend money. Here's our, so that's what goes into our inventory. So if we go to the store here, we have packs, kind of like Tiger. You get the money as you play. I've played, like I said, I think 18 holes and 3 9 holes, and I've got 15,000 coins, and I haven't been playing that great either. So I think I only shot under par one time, and it was on easy. I played pro 3 times and shot over par, easy one time and shot under par. So 60,000 for the extreme pack. You can also add credits with real money, which I will not do. I don't like that. I don't mind buying DLC stuff if it's something that interests me, but I don't like buying money to buy packs for it. I just don't like it. So I guess I could buy an elite pack. You get 5 elite items with a chance of up to 3 being extreme. So here we get 5 extreme. So basically, you know, we could buy some pro pack, 2 of these, you get 5 items with a chance of 3 being elite. So you can, you know, you can buy elites. You know, you decide what you want to do. I haven't bought anything, so I don't really know what to buy, actually. These are, you know, 3 randomly selected amateur boosters with a chance of getting a pro, elite, or extreme. Maybe we'll buy 2 pro packs instead of just buying 1 pack of elite. Let's do that. I have no idea how this works, so let's purchase. Sure. This is how you get all your collectibles in the game. So let's see what we got. We got a shot bar speed 15% minus. That's pretty cool. You know, it's like a 3-click system. You click it once, the bar goes. You click it for your power, and then it comes down. And you click it again for your accuracy. So that'll shorten that speed. We got some new woods, which is pretty cool, it looks like. Strike and spin bonus, but accuracy is not as good. Putting boost 10% booster. Getting corporate Kirby. Looks like it's I don't know what that is. Outfit, maybe? A shirt? And an iron. With actually bonus on everything. Big time. Holy shite. Okay, that's pretty good. I can't tell if these are elite or what. Like, did I get elite stuff? Maybe they're all blue, so I probably got all pro. Superior, Cyclone, oh, those must be the companies, like that Cyclone company or something. Okay, so done. And that's probably another pro pack. Yeah, I see they're different colors. You can see that as a flipping. And I got all pro stuff every time, so that didn't really help. So we got new woods there. We got another thing of woods. We got a putter, an accuracy boost, and Astrid Krampus, whatever that is. It looks like a shirt for Astrid. I think boosters are like you use them for one round type of thing. Like we get 10% accuracy for one round of golf. Whereas I think that one perk is actually something we can keep for good. So that's pretty good. So let's go to our caddy and golfer setup here. Let's go to our inventory. I haven't yet to do this, so it's going to take me a second to get through this stuff. I haven't bought anything, like I said. We have Greenheart Woods equipped. Does this go for every... Okay, let's see if we go to our inventory and we... Which ones do we want? The Green Shade Woods. These are all one star. Yeah, I'll give a look. This is a bonus minus. I couldn't really care less about spin on a wood. So we get more accuracy and more strike. Foliage impact minus 10. I'm assuming maybe if we go in a high rough, maybe it's what, 10% less, but it knocks it down 10%. That's what I would think. Oh, on the bottom there's a set bonus too on the right. So if you get a whole set of green shade, it looks like you get a putting bonus. So everything has a set bonus too, which is cool. See this? I'm already into this. I love shit like this. Tiger doesn't have this anymore. As they have, you can get clothes and shit, but like a freaking kilt. But I like having clubs where they change the way you play, and then you get bonuses for collecting a set of shit. That's when I get addicted to crap. So which one do I want? Accuracy. I'd rather have 76 power. That's pretty good. Power needs to go up. My accuracy goes down, though. My strike. You know, let's go with the Desperado. I want the power. Okay. So my irons. I only got one thing of irons. It raises pretty much everything. Well, it looks like my strike went down. But everything else goes up. Let's put those on. And we get a strike plus 32 if we get the set. Wedges we didn't get. We got a new putter, which is massively increased our stats. We didn't get balls. We got caddy perks. So that, I believe, stays good for good. I don't think so. So shot bar speed minus 15%. Yeah, I like that. Here's our boosters. Next, I think these are a one round thing. Accuracy for one round, putted for one round. So I equipped this through inventory. Does that mean every golfer has it? I think you can actually come in here and change each golfer individually. So let's check out her. No, it only was him. So if I want to play as her, I would have to do it all over again with just her selected. She's already accurate, so let's give her the same stuff. I actually have been playing better with her than him, maybe because she's more accurate. You can't do caddy pack stuff here. Okay. But oh, you go to caddy setup. So there's our caddies. This is Kirby Campbell. Oh, I already showed that one, didn't I? Yeah, I did. An Astron, okay. So shot bar speed 50%, no perk equipped. Change perks. Okay, we equipped that, so they both have that perk now. And what's his skill again? Oh yeah, she gives you putt preview, and he gives you kind of like a shot preview thing. Okay. Oh, we also got new clothes too, didn't we? Where did we change that? Didn't we get that? Oh, flannel. There we go. Now getting corporate. Okay, flannel, getting corporate. Flannel. And then Astrid, ocean spray, or Krampus with the, like, this evil dude. I like that. We'll stick with that. So confirm. Okay. And did he stay the same, even though I didn't actually confirm his thing? Yeah, okay. Alright, so that's that setup. So we bought our first packs of stuff, I've got some unlockables. So let's go into career. I haven't done this yet. So you see there's a lot, all these different circuits here that are unlocked as you level. Looks like you need to be 42 to unlock this special rules one. I did unlock the second course, I believe it was level 6 to unlock it. I think it might have been 7, I think it was 6 to unlock that. And each one has, so there's bronze, silver, and gold, it looks like. So there's a lot of stuff to do. Emperor's Garden is the third course. Burning Sands is the fourth. So, I say there's only 4 courses. So let's start a city park. Select that. We got all these different ones to do. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Well, there's 9 total. There's not 9 bronze, silver, and gold. It's just, yeah, if you get 9 gold, obviously is what you want. But there's 9 things to do here. So, it's, and then as you play, like, monorail meet, when you actually win this, you unlock that new character there. So. And each golfer actually has their own thing, too, where, like, the guy hits, I'll show that off when it comes up. So we got warm up. Special challenge of 3 holes, short tees, easy pins, calm wind. Cool. Achieve a score of 3 under or better for gold. Complete for bronze. Par or better for silver. 3 under or better for gold on 3 holes. So that might not be that easy. Okay, so Raiko here, she has Tesla Field, which is actually pretty awesome. It makes like a magnetic field around the hole, and if you hit within that, it helps drive the ball toward the hole closer. It's pretty cool. I only got to work once. And then that's her thing, right? Yeah, applies an electrical charge to the ball and cup. When the ball is close enough, the energy field draws it toward the hole. Pretty cool. And then Frank basically hits the ball 10% farther. He gets the power shots. Let's do Raiko for this. I've been doing better with her. Frank has the more power, but she's more accurate. I've definitely been doing better with her than him so far. And we'll do Kirby. No, let's do Astrid, because I'll use that putt preview if I need it. Okay, even though she's got that evil thing on. So let's. And we could equip boosters if we want, but we're not going to do that here. Okay, so let's finally get into this thing. Sorry. So I'm trying to, you know, explain how what I know of the game in this first video. If these are pretty short, I'll probably do multiple ones. The other cool thing about this is, see right, my one, number one there? That's my longest drive ever on this course. Here's the first hole, City Park course. There's a monorail that goes through it. It's kind of cool. I haven't hit the train yet or nothing. And then there's a world record, 824 yards. I have no idea what the hell that means. Who knows? You know, all these games where they have world records and shit, it always seems like they're bugged. Somebody can cheat it. But what's cool is every shot you take on basically every hole, they save your best, and you're constantly trying to beat that. And if you beat it, you get bonus XP, which is cool. Okay, so we need to get 300 better to get that main prize. So just like Hot Shots, you use the left stick to aim. Y takes you to the pin. Okay. No, or it takes you to your accurate, to your aimer. We got wind on the top right, 3 miles. This is a 400-yard hole. Now, you see on the left there, above the ball, it says hold with that mark. That means that's her special power. We only have one to use. On the right is the caddy power. We only have one of those to use. Because there's that one little orange mark on the left. The same thing on the right. It's not orange right now, but that's for green only. That's why it's grayed out. On the bottom left, you can actually move top spin, side spin, all the different spins on the ball. And then everything else is pretty much, you know, it's pretty standard. So let's do a 3-click guy. Not the best shot. But it'll be okay. Wow, I'm hitting the ball. That's crazy. I have so much more power than I had. I was hitting the ball about 210 with her before. So this will make the game much easier. So that's my new personal best, because obviously I had new clubs. It was 219. That's the farthest I hit it before. So I basically went almost 30 yards farther with those new clubs. So yeah, I got 50 XP for having a new personal best, and then some more bonus XP around just for my shot in general. The one thing, it does take account uphill, downhill on your shots, but it does not seem to take account side hole lies. So you could be on the craziest side hole lie, and they'll still hit it straight. Which, that's the only thing that's kind of like a little bit, like, really? You can do that better than that? So we're uphill a little bit. But we also have a win at our back. So we'll put some backspin on this baby. Try to rest it up there with a 7-iron. That's a perfect shot. A PhD. I hit that tree? I think I hit that tree. Shit. Wow. Alright, well, I'm in trouble for getting a gold here. Oh, then I'm going to get a gold. X, we do a pitch shot here. Obviously, it's not going to roll as much. Let it soft. Go, go in.
Great shot.
And basically, every world record for every shot now going toward the green is gone in. So you're never going to get a world record unless you hit it. Think you can stop me? Alright, so we got a par, which is not really what I wanted, but these are, I'm going to basically record my first time through all these, as long as I pass them. But if I don't get a gold, I'm not going to be like, stop and restart my record. If I don't get a gold, I don't get a gold, I'll just get it later. Alright, so here is hole 2, I'll just show off the holes a little bit, because it's pretty cool looking. So obviously the world record is hitting in the cup. My best is 12 feet away, 12 and a half feet away. So you can see that. It's really cool that every shot you take, you're trying to beat your own best. I don't know, I just like that. And it doesn't matter with what character, I believe, just you yourself. You know, that's what matters. So we're going to, this is par 3. Let's try out our her special power on this hole. That makes sense. So we got a little bit of wind. Not much, it's a little bit uphill. So we hold X, and you'll see that there's a thing going around. If we get the ball anywhere within that magnetic field, it's going to draw toward the cup.
All charged up.
So that hopefully will be somewhere within that field. I don't know if it just has to hit it or has to land by it. There we go. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Suck it back.
Great approach.
Oh, it was going too hard. I had one that actually landed kind of in it, and it really drew toward the cup. It didn't go in, but it was probably 2 feet away. We still got closer than we did before. So we got a lot of bonus XP for that. That was a good shot. Okay, so we're going a little bit right, a little bit left. Probably just hit this thing pretty much straight. Button's only two click. We'll probably, hopefully we get a silver out of this. I think we just had to play par better, it said. So we got a par 5 here. You do have to, like, if you're in the rough, it does take into account distance. You got hit hard out of the rough, but it still doesn't take account the side hill lies. 319 for the world record. I don't know what the 800-yard drive was. Obviously, that was goofy. 319 is obviously reachable. It actually seems almost too short to be a world record. If you go a little right of the green, you actually yank it a bit, and a little before it, you push it. That's gonna roll right off the fairway. That's a huge lie. There's a butterfly right there. Pretty cool. So you can see now on the left, with this club, 75 to 90% rough. I believe that I'm going to get hit 75 to 90% distance. I won't be able to get it there 100%. So we gotta add a little more to it, basically. But this being a par 5 really doesn't matter. We'll just hit a 3-iron up here. That should be fine.
Try and keep
it
up.
Is uphill. If hopefully it gets over those trap. There's a trap. Okay, that's fine. So we got one.
Good recovery.
We should have a pretty good shot. If we're about... I don't know if we can pitch from 100. Seems kind of far. We have a 9-iron. It allows us to do it with... We could pitch with a 6. That just seems kind of weird, doesn't it? We could pitch with a 5. That seems kind of odd, too. Gives us a good accuracy, though. So maybe that's what we're supposed to be doing here. Let's try it.
Easier than a PhD.
You see the green bar rose. It was wider because we're doing a pitch shot. Look at that. Going. Oh, if that went in, we could have got the gold.
For a birdie.
Nice. 200's not bad in our first career. I think it was on easy. So I had easy pitch and everything, but still.
Results.
This video is obviously longer than it needs to be because a lot of the discussion in the beginning, I was trying to show off stuff that I knew about the game. So we're probably going to end it here. It's 22 minutes already. That's crazy. I didn't think it was going to be that long. Career event win. And achievements, of course. We got pro. We did not get elite. We got 750 money, though, for that. Whatever they call it. I'll call it rupees. I call it the name rupees, like Zelda, if there's not a name for it. So here, all the stuff that you've done goes into your XP here, and it shows you exactly what you got. We got 1,200, 1,850 rupees. And we're level 8 now, right? Yeah. Oh, no, we're almost level 8. We could go right to the store from here, too, if we wanted to buy stuff. And they show these advertisements for things I'm assuming are in the store. Exotech. Clubs. Kind of cool. So we did not get the gold, but we can't always replay it to get the gold. So we have a couple tournaments coming up here. I'll probably use the guy in the next one just to show him off. So in the next video, we'll start here with City Park New Leaf Open. It's a 9-hole tournament. Short tees, easy pins, calm wind. And win the event for gold. 6th or better for bronze. And 4th or better for silver. Okay. And a lot of rupees. 4,000 rupees for that one. Alright, cool. So, thanks for watching, everybody. And we'll see you guys all in the next